Alright guys, we are back for another Ablaze devotion on YouTube. This is number two, of course that's four, so number two. We're excited about it. Last week we talked about Christmas, which I hope you guys had a wonderful Christmas.
Yes, I hope you got everything that you wanted.
Yes, I do too. And we haven't seen each other for like 2 weeks because there hasn't been any church, but next week we have youth service, so everybody come out, bring someone with you. It's going to be awesome.
Turn up.
Oh gosh. Okay, so we just started a new year. We're excited about it, or we're going to start a new year. I don't even know what today's date is, but anyways. Production shaking his head. But when is this, Aaron?
Probably the first.
January 1st.
New year. So anyways, we want to talk real quick about putting last year behind you, because you can't have a wonderful year this year, 2014, if you're so thinking about maybe some of the mistakes you made in 2013. Now listen, nobody's perfect. We've all been there. We've all made mistakes, myself included, even though Rachel's a little bit more perfect than I am. We all make mistakes. The important thing is don't identify with your mistake. Yeah. Identify with who you are in Jesus, and be sure that you don't let, lots of people, what they do is they make a mistake and then they run away from God because they feel like they've let Him down, they've let themselves down. What's so important is that we make sure that 2014 is a year of us running to God.
Yeah.
You know, not running away from Him. So we want to read this scripture real quick. It's Philippians 3, verse 12 through 13. It says, I don't mean to say that I've achieved these things or that I've already reached perfection, but I keep working towards that day, which I finally will be all that Christ saved me for and wants me to be. No, dear brothers and sisters, I'm still not all that I should be, but I'm focusing all my energies on this one thing, forgetting the past and looking forward to what lies ahead. And so the Apostle Paul, he said, listen, I know I'm not perfect. I've made mistakes. If you guys know anything about the Apostle Paul, he made a lot of mistakes. I mean, he was killing Christians, putting them in prison. I mean, dude just made some radical mistakes. But he said, I focus all my energies on this and I forget those things which are behind me. Listen, it doesn't happen naturally. You have to work at forgetting your mistakes.
Yeah, you do.
And if you don't let it, you know, your mistakes will haunt you and they'll hold you back. And so we've got to be sure that we look forward to where God wants us to go. So as we go into 2014, look at who God wants you to be. Not who you were in 2013, but look at who God wants you to be, and then find ways to move forward in that. What do you think?
Yeah, I mean, you can't let your mistakes weigh you down. They will drown you. They will annihilate you. You just have to give it to God, let it go, and then move forward. Because if you don't, I mean, your life will be dramatically changed if you don't let it go.
In a negative way.
In a negative way, yeah.
And the worst thing you can do is, like the Bible says, don't compare yourselves among yourselves. And so like, well, this person, they don't make the same mistakes I make, or they didn't do this or they didn't do that. That's just foolish and it's just nonsense. Just focus on who you are in Christ Jesus and what God has done for you through Jesus Christ. And just understand, listen, we're all human. We were all born with a sin nature. Jesus came to save us. The Bible says He came to seek and save those which were lost. And so we don't want you to be like, man, I messed up, and then just begin to look at your life negative. Instead, look at your life like, you know what, Jesus saved me, and because of Jesus, I have so much potential, and just as the scriptures say, I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me.
Yeah, amen.
Go ahead.
I was just gonna bring this up. I mean, the Lord's been dealing with me a lot. It's really easy to look around and be like, well, so-and-so, you know, why did they get that? Or why didn't that happen to them? It's really easy to do that. But I just remember as a child when my friends would not get in trouble for the same thing that we all did together. And it was because my mother expected so much out of me, and she was like, they're not my kids, you're my kid, and so you need to fix this and do right.
That's really good.
And so, you know, God's our parent, and you have to think, you know, hey, they might, you know, people around you may not know the word, may not know the Lord like you do. And so you kind of have to set a better standard for yourself than other people.
And that's so true. Like when you see people at school, well, why do they get to do this and why do they get to do that? Just remember, you're a child of the Most High God.
Yeah.
And so the most important thing you can do in 2014 is live as a child of the Most High God. And so, hey, listen, spend some time in the Bible with God, enjoying your relationship with Him. If you have any questions, you can look us up at Ablaze Youth Ministries. You can email us. It'll be on our YouTube channel. We love you guys so much. We'll see you next week at 7 o'clock for youth service.
Happy New Year.
Oh yeah, Happy New Year.